In this video, we'll show you how to add user authentication to a WeWeb project. We'll show you how to add the WeWeb Auth plugin and manage users, how to allow users to sign up and log into your app, and how to restrict access to a page so that only authenticated users can access it. Let's take our customer portal project. What we'll do first is in the plugins tab, we will get the WeWeb Auth plugin. In future videos and in dedicated user documentation articles, you can find information on how to use other authentication plugins, including token-based authentication. For now, we'll work with the WeWeb Auth. We will add the plugin, and there's not much we need to do. The first step, configuration, shows the emails that are sent to new users when you invite them yourself to join your application, and we'll show you how to do that in a second. And the second email is a template for when the user forgets their password and needs a new one. And again, we'll show you how users can request a new password in a few seconds. You cannot change these email templates directly in WeWeb. If you need to change them, please contact us. We will do this manually for you. We have this restriction in place to avoid security issues with people doing phishing through those email. But if you contact us, we will take care of that for you. No problem. Let's click continue. The first thing we're invited to do is to decide which page unauthenticated users should be redirected to. So when a user is not signed in, where do we want to direct them? It could be our homepage if we had a public homepage. In our case, we want to redirect unauthenticated users to a login page. We don't have one yet, so what we'll do is we'll create a page, call it login, and create that page. We'll leave it empty for now and go back to our plugin and select the login page to redirect users when they're not signed in. That's it. That's all we need to do to add user authentication. When we click continue, we see that we can start managing users, managing roles, and managing private access pages. Let's start by managing users. So we can click here when we're in the WeWeb Auth plugin. Or if we're ever anywhere else, we can reopen that tab by clicking on this user icon here. So here we have our list of users, and we don't have any users yet. We can add one manually. That's what I'll do. And here we can generate an automatic password, or we could set one if we wanted to. We'll just generate a password, and we could send an invitation, or we could decide not to send an invitation. In this case, I'm a new user to this app. I want to inform myself that I have been invited to use this application, so I will send myself an invitation. Let's create the user. Now we have it in WeWeb. And I'm going to go ahead in my emails and find the email, the invitation email. There it is. Let me show you this email. You see, it's a simple email. It follows the template that we had. And what I'll do is I'll copy this password and go back here. Now you see, I could also import users, select a CSV file to import users. And once I have users, I can also export users in a CSV. Okay, it's great that we can add users manually or import users in WeWeb directly, but maybe we also want users to be able to sign up by themselves. Let's look at how we could do that. The first thing we'll want to do is we'll want to create a new page, this time to sign up. So a sign up page. It's created, it's an empty page. And now what we can do is we can go to our add panel. And because we added the WeWeb Auth plugin, we have access to UI elements for the WeWeb Auth. In this case, we want the signup section. So it's ready made with the information for users to sign up to our web app. You see here a little lightning bolt that tells us that there's a workflow. There's a signup workflow that comes by default with the UI element. And what it does, it uses the WeWeb Auth action signup. When you add the WeWeb Auth plugin, you have lots of new no-code workflow actions that you can use. In this case, we're using the signup action, and we are binding the input fields from the form that we have on the page, from the form that we just dropped on our page. We're saying that the email field is this email variable, the password field is this password variable, and the name field is this name variable. This is all the information you need to create a new user in WeWeb, the email, password, and name. Now, we could add an action to change page when the user, once the user has signed up, we want to redirect them to the login page so that they can log in. Let's try signing up in preview mode. Let me try to sign up as Joyce. Joyce at weweb.io. And let me try a password here. Now, I'm going to test this workflow, and I can tell you right now, I'm going to get an error message. There we go. So the account already exists. The account with this email address already exists. Remember, I created it manually here. But we will show you in a separate video how to handle errors like this. It can happen very often with authentication if the user is already signed up, if they choose a password that doesn't respect the security rules that you asked for, if a user tries to log in with an incorrect password. So we will show you in a dedicated video how to handle those user errors. For now, let's just create a new address. Let's try with test 2 and try to sign up here. And there we go. We're redirected to our login page. And in our user tab, if I refresh, I will see this new user. Now I'm on my login page and it's empty. So let's again go to our add panel and look for UI elements prepared for the WeWeb Auth plugin. We have a login section here. Let's choose it. Again, we have a workflow on the container, and this workflow is predetermined. It uses the login action from the WeWeb Auth plugin, and we don't know yet where we want to redirect the user after login. So this is where I will complete the action, and I will choose to redirect them to this page, the display data page. I'm going to try this with the password that I received earlier from in the email. I will paste it here. And then what I want to do is show you that when I log in, I'm redirected to this page, but also in my variables, I see the variables from WeWeb Auth that I am authenticated, and I see my email address here. Okay, we added a user authentication plugin. We also created pages and workflows for users to sign up and log in to our app. Now we want to gate content. We want to protect a page so that even if someone has the URL of a page with private information, they are not able to access it. We want to restrict access to that page. In our page setting here, we'll look at the page that we want to protect. And here in the settings, in private access, instead of saying that everybody can access this page, we will click here and say that only authenticated users can access this page. And later on, when we add user roles and user groups, we will be able to restrict access to this page only to authenticated users who are part of a specific group. For now, we'll leave it at that. We will save this. And now we see that this page is protected because it has a little lock here. The globe icon signifies that the page is accessible to anyone, authenticated or not. The lock here tells us that we restricted the access to the page. That means that even if someone has the URL of this customer portal page, if they try to access it and they're not logged in, they will be redirected to the page that we defined here. In this case, it's the login page. That's it. That's how you add user authentication and gate content in WeWeb. In other videos, we'll show you how to set up a forgot password flow. So when a user forgets their password, they can choose a new one. We'll also show you how to display helpful messages when a user creates an error. For example, if an existing user tries to sign up again, or if they try to log in with an incorrect password. In level 2 of the WeWeb Academy, we will also show you how to use other authentication plugins and how to work with user roles and permissions.